sound system that we're using here a second, just didn't make quite sense. Oh, there we go, thank you. Running back and forth between that microphone and the smoke microphone. So hey, thank you very much for coming this evening and welcome to our 2023 Spring Concert and Awards. We're obviously got a big night showcasing both of our jazz bands, our concert band and our symphonic band, as well as all of our class recognitions, some special band awards that have been really given out since the start of the opening of the school. So we really hope you enjoy this evening's performances. We are going to start tonight with our Jazz 2. Mr. Blume is kind of our director of jazz studies here at Central Cross. I assist him with conducting the Jazz 2 ensemble. Let you just to give a very quick insight into this piece. Really what these students have been working on for a good chunk of this last grading period is soloing. And really kind of was initiated by our student teacher, Mr. Miller, which you will see later. But yeah, so you're gonna see some of these students. We worked on what's called the blues. The students learned a blues scale, and then they, some of these brave souls, decided, hey, yes, I'll come up and I will improvise jazz music that's based off of a lot of improvisation. So they are on the spot and be creating their own music for you as they come up to the microphone. All right, so this is, actually, let me go ahead and tell you who our soloists are going to be for this tune. It's gonna start off with, and if you guys just raise your hand real quick when I say your name, Alexa Johnson, Nolan Dix, Christian Sandel, Christopher Bustamante, Jack Callender, and Ian Price. All right, so this is Blues 5-5. Thank you.
quick switcheroo to Jazz 1.
This is Jazz 1, and this is kind of an interesting class because we start in our first day of class is in November after the marching band season. During the marching band season, we go a period and a half, fourth period and then half, fifth period. So we have that time to perfect and practice the marching band show. It takes a lot of time. And then once we get into November, then students have the option, and these students did take that option of sticking around for that first half or fifth period to practice in jazz. So, you know, quick kind of 20 minutes, and then we're on our way for lunch, and these students have certainly learned a lot and learned a lot too. So it's been a good year, and it's also what we'll kind of demonstrate here is we have a lot of seniors in this group. We're going to miss you guys a ton. Really, really gonna miss you guys. Yeah. So we'll have all this after this. Yeah. Miss you guys. So after this first song, I want you to kind of like see how many seniors are in this group and how much of an impact they're gonna leave. But we're gonna hear first from Cole Atkins playing his senior solo, Makin' Whoopee. So let's see these seniors. Can we have all the seniors, please? You know, some of you are already standing, but can you at least give a wave or stand up, please? State seniors, give a wave, stand up. Yeah? All right, and featuring one more senior that's played in jazz band all 4 years and has done a lot with his jazz studies and is going to school a couple years to study in jazz. So very, very cool. So hopefully you enjoy this piece, jazz classic, In a Sentimental Mood, senior soloist Logan Dickerson.
Thank you.
So part of the spring band concert at the high school, there's many national awards that are awarded by the Instrumentalist magazine that are commonly and widely recognized as some of the top music awards from high schools all around the world and really all around America. And there is a top award for jazz called the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award. The Louis Armstrong Jazz Award is intended to honor the outstanding jazz musician at high schools across the country. The award was established in 1971 to recognize outstanding achievements of an instrumentalist in the field of jazz as demonstrated through superior musicianship, character, and individual creativity. This year's Louis Armstrong Jazz Award winner is Logan Dickerson.
Enjoy the weekend with your students. And now introducing our freshman class. First up, Lydia Alexander, Emma Allison, Valeria Maria Arita Rahalo, Amanda Baldwin, Michaela Borg, Jack Callender, Annalise Carter, Caleb Combrus, Ethan Copeland, Elizabeth Foreman, Mackenzie Cox, Olivia Cox, yeah. Nolan Dix, Jasmine Dean McNeil, Ace Fox, Katie Gaines, Aaron Harper, Benjamin Hershey, Lex Heffley, Josue Hakome Torres, Reese Jefferson, Karen Jones, Alexa Johnson, Mark Johnson, Kaya Kinsey, Madeline Kisla, Neil Kudik, Maya Lawhorn, Aaron Little, Josephine Little, Preston Liu, Cameron McCormick, Owen McMahon, Indiana Northrup, Michael Bonham, Ian Price, Emily Reinhardt, Levin Song, Christian Samuel, Abigail Shiplett, Ariana Tetablanco, Sarang Willis, Julia Worth, and Randy Wolfer. One more hand of clapping here for our first class.
Very, very involved in volunteering right away. So we're very, very thankful and appreciative of all of you that did do that. But here's a quick fun fact. 46 of our 111 band members this year were freshmen. So just over 40% of our band is freshmen, and obviously they did an outstanding job this year. So.
Thank you. Thank you. year. They
thank you.
finishing getting lined up. Quick announcement here. So basically, for each class, there's kind of an award. As a freshman, you receive your Central Crossing Band Members Badge. So basically, it's kind of a tradition in a lot of band programs across America to have a band jacket and wear the patch on that band jacket if they so choose. Obviously, this can be hung up anywhere or utilized however they wish. But the intention was to have something that, you know, when they kind of felt like band is they're a member, they're a part of our band family, and then they can wear that proudly. For each year that they continue within the band program, they're going to be receiving these silver stars. So as a freshman, you would receive one star. By the time you're a senior, then you will have four stars, obviously. And then we're not taking the time to distribute those this evening at the same time. They will be receiving all these awards in school on Monday. All right, so next up, I'd like to introduce Mr. Donnie Ross, the percussion director here at Central Cross High School.
Thank you, Phil. I just wanted to take a moment to introduce and recognize the efforts of these young people for the indoor percussion this season. First of all, we're 24 in total, and well, I know we're 24 in total, and here's why. 17 of them had never played these instruments before, and that presented a pretty huge challenge for us this season. In 2022, Central Crossing was promoted in WGI from their A class to inter class to open class, the intermediate class, and it presented quite a few challenges. Anybody that knows the history of Central Crossing knows that they've skated the line for a long time between A class and open class, and we decided this year, rather than coming out and potentially being promoted later, to just tackle that challenge head on, and we stayed in that class for the entire season. They were able to achieve third place at the WGI Dayton Percussion Regional, second place,
junior class of the band, the class of 2024. First is Addison Bailey, and Peyton Bowling, and Cole Bush, Elizabeth Carney, Taylor Carter, Lexi Christensen, Allison Dillon, Aaron Owens, Abigail Franks, Ashley Johnson, Rachel Johnson, Blake Lang, Casey Lattingham, Logan Little, Emily Menda, Sydney Smallwood, and Nelson Wolpe.
Hey guys, what's your
sophomores, or the workhorses of the band, definitely a junior class, kind of feel like, you know, as part of this upperclassmen label, really kind of the backbone of our band program. This class's freshman year was really like no other class had, you know, experienced. And through all those challenges, they chose to stick with it. Obviously, looking at our numbers here, this class was affected through choices the students made, with having to do and deal with band, going through COVID, and making choices not to participate. Obviously, we don't dwell on that. We dwell on these outstanding young men and women who made the choice to persevere, show some resilience, and get through on the other side and still get to do what they love and enjoy. So congratulations to our junior class.
Thank you.
incredible support of the administration here at Sentimental Class High School. So, I just want to always thank them for their unending support of these students, obviously of every organization within the school. But please know that behind the scenes, we receive incredible support from our school's administration. So I have to thank Mr. Ferris, and he's here tonight back in the back. So thank you, Mr. Ferris.
Is the Central Crossing Symphonic Band. They are under the direction of Mr. Eric Hubbell.
This piece was actually written in 1910.
Pulse. He actually wrote a lot of music for orchestras back in that time. In fact, a little side story, Pulse wrote a piece called The Planets. One of the movements from The Planets is called Jupiter. And one of the melodies from Jupiter is what you hear when we sing and play the Central Crossing alma mater. So this particular piece, written in 1909, was really one of the first pieces that convinced other notable composers to write music for a wind band. So this piece was kind of like the launching point for most of the wind band literature that you hear today. So this is a first suite in E flat by Holst. There's also three movements. It's very customary that we do not applaud between movements. We applaud at the end. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
presenting the band senior class of 2023. And starting with our first senior is Cole Atkins. Education, but plans on being an industrial electrician. Yeah. Our next senior is Richie Cowan. Richie will be working towards a career in computer programming. Our next senior is Rosalie Daniels. Rosalie will be attending The Ohio State University to major in radiation therapy. Our next senior is Brayden Dean. Brayden will be attending The Ohio State University and is thankful for all the friends he made in the Central Crossing Band. Our next senior is Logan Dickerson. In the meantime, Logan is planning on pursuing martial arts while continuing his private lessons on saxophone. Logan was awarded the Southwestern City Schools Education Association Music Scholarship. Our next senior is Brian Frenson. Study environmental sciences. One thing Brian wanted to share from his experience in the Central Crossing Band was that if you have a goal, go for it. Yeah. Our next senior is Kyan Hamilton. Symphonic band and percussion ensemble. Next senior is Lee Kung. Lee will be attending Columbus State University to major in marketing. Senior is Kirsten Needles. Kirsten will be attending Columbus College of Art and Design and majoring in photography. Kirsten was awarded the CCAD Discovery District Scholarship worth $16,000 and renewable for 4 years. Kirsten plans on becoming a self-employed photographer and says that band helped her learn accountability, responsibility, and respect. Our next senior is Raya Smith. Raya will be attending the University of Kentucky on a pre-dentistry track. Raya was awarded the William C. Parker Scholarship, and in the future plans on auditioning for the independent world-class Winter Guard, Lexus. Our next senior is Ben Stoneking. To major in political science and minor in music, and was awarded the Trustees Scholarship. Our next senior is Jamie Younger. Yeah. be attending the University of Akron to major in social work, child welfare. Our next senior is Alicia Vogelsong. State University to major in psychology and minor in music. Our next senior is Chloe Watkins. Chloe will be attending Lipscomb University to major in animation. Chloe says, I'm grateful for all the friends I've made and the opportunities I've been given through band. High school would not have been so much fun without it. Our next senior is Matthew Wheeler. Hamilton Honorary Scholarship of the Southwestern City Schools Educational Foundation. From OSU, he received the Trustee Scholarship, the President's Affordability Grant, and the University Grant Scholarship. Matthew also received a scholarship from the Columbus Builders Exchange and from the Central Crossing High School Student Council. Matthew plans on continuing his involvement in band at OSU and is very grateful for all those who have supported him in band over the years.
Fortunate that they have in some way made a positive impact on our lives. For the
past 20 years, I feel extremely fortunate to have been a colleague to one of these people. A person that day after day, year after year, shows seemingly endless capacity to provide support to all of the students, the teachers, administrators, clubs, teams, and ensembles that call Central Crossing their home. We, the band, definitely felt that support. In fact, I would even go as far as saying that that the support that he provided us really helped the students in Central Crossing Band as a whole be able to experience success. That person is Mr. Doug Harvey. Mr. Harvey, welcome to the
The National School Colored Art Award is was established at Central Crossing to recognize a Color Guard member for their invaluable leadership, outstanding levels of performance, unwavering commitment to their team, and overall dedication to excellence. This individual has truly made a positive impact on the continued growth and achievements made by the Central Crossing Color Guard, and I'm proud to say that she's very deserving of this award. This year, the National Color Guard Award goes to Ryan Smith.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much for coming out tonight, celebrating an amazing year for all of our students. We're going to finally play our last piece.
The seniors wanted to get something to recognize Mr. Hubbell and all of his leadership over our past 4 years. And with this band program, it simply would not be what it is today without Mr. Hubbell.
Congratulations on being